This is a practice exercise from page 185 in the textbook. So they're asking us to write a standard enthalpy of formation equation. So standard enthalpy of formation tells us the enthalpy involved in forming a substance from elements in their standard state. So if we look at the substance that we're writing this reaction for, it's carbon tetrachloride, which means it's made up of two elements, carbon and chlorine. So what we need to figure out is what are the standard states of carbon and chlorine. If you don't know off the top of your head what the standard states for these elements are, the best place to look is the appendix in the back of your textbook. If you look at the appendix, you'll notice that for some substances, they have delta H of formation values, that's this value here, delta H, F, of zero. When a substance has a delta H of formation value of zero, so no enthalpy of formation, that means it's because it doesn't have to form. It's already in its standard state. You'll also see this come up when we perform some calculations. Sometimes that'll look like information is missing about an element, but it's not that the information is missing, it's that if it's an element in its standard state, the enthalpy formation is already zero. So we can look up enthalpies for our two compounds, carbon and chlorine, and see if we can try to figure out what their standard states might be. So as I look here for carbon, I can see that down here I can find carbon, and I see this value of zero for carbon when it is in graphite. So carbon as graphite has an enthalpy of formation of zero. That is the standard state for carbon. I can do the same thing for chlorine. If I look at where in this table I've got zero, I see that's for chlorine gas. Notice that it's a diatomic. So in its standard state, chlorine is a diatomic element. So when I go back up here to write my equation, I'm going to make sure that I start with carbon in its standard state, which is graphite. I'm going to react that with chlorine, which is Cl2, and a gas in its standard state to form carbon tetrachloride, which is a liquid, as they tell us in the problem. Last thing we want to do is make sure this is balanced. There's one carbon atom on each side of the reaction, which is fine. We just need to make sure we have four chlorine atoms on each side, so a coefficient of 2 in front of the chlorine molecule. So this is how you write standard enthalpy of formation reactions.